In today's class, we will discuss some problems of C++. This comes under the module 1. So, the problems we are mainly focusing on predicting the outputs. So, the program will be given to you and let's try to predict the output based on the command. In C++, both the output as well as the programming statements are mutually dependent. That means based on the output type or the type of script you need in the output, you want to modify the programming. So that's why they are called as interrelated. The same program can be presented by different way. Either it can be through the algorithm or the concept or idea, as well as it can be presented in a different way by the output types. So let's see the problem number one. This is a problem to find the sum of two numbers. So it's a straight problem because we want to call integer A, we want to call the integer B and to add the value and to print it out. But based on the statements inside this program, the output will vary. What about the output value will vary? Output style, the way of arranging the output lines will vary. So let's try to predict the output based on this input and also on a check whether this program will work. Okay, so you will first type as a first statement hash without any space include then a white space io string. It need not end with a semicolon, please note. Using namespace std, using space namespace space std, it should end with a semicolon. So both the first two statements are correct. Next we have the main function integer int, okay, main bracket. So this is the correct syntax. Then we are opening with the curly brace, is correct. So up to the line 1, 2, 3 is a blank line or the blank space. Now I choose 3rd and 4th is correct. C out, correct up to here with all the arrows. \n\n. So it will be printing in a new line. Print the sum of two numbers. Note that the entire script or this entire wordings are given in the double quotes. This must. So this will be printed out. Print the sum of two numbers is fine. Up to this point with a colon. It should end with a semicolon, so correct. Then we have the cout. Nothing is there, just put a line, like the breaking lines. Okay. Then again, next line. Cout, the sum of 29 and 30 is. So we are not giving any input to this one. We are not asking the user to input in value. We just put some addition directly in the cout statement. The sum of 29 and 30 is ending with a colon. With then we have the double quotes. So this will be printed as such. Then again continue. Cout is continuing. 29 plus 30 will be displayed directly. It is continuing and there is a nest line option. So we'll see the output. Should end with a curly brace. Here return 0 is not required because we are not returning any value to any other function in this program. Return 0 we used for the previous programs because it is a common syntax. If you didn't write even return 0 for very simple problems where there is no returning of values happening, program will work. Yeah. So print the sum of two numbers, colon, this line as such and the sum of 39 and 30 is, this will add and value will be displayed. You can copy this or you can write this program in any of the online compilers which I have shown and try whether you are getting the correct output as I displayed here. As a next problem, this was telling about the in different ways we can do this program. Okay, same problem, same header file, same namespace std is kind of same, integer main, curly bracket is correct. After that one, we are using cout with the arrow marks, print the sum of two numbers. So this line is correct, this line is correct, this line is correct, curly brace is correct, cout, the same thing as we seen before, correct, lines is correct. Then we are defining integer a, it should end with a semicolon, correct, integer b, correct, integer sum. So we are defining three variables, a, b, sum. We are defining directly inside the program that a is equal to 29, that's correct, b 30, sum we are defining as a plus b. So directly under the sum variable, the value of a plus b will be stored. Then c out, correct, put in inverted double quotes, the sum of then value directly a. So a value will be the sum of a. So sum of 30 will come here. Not sum of 30, because we are putting this one inside the double quotes. So only the character will be printing out. I'm sorry. The sum of A and B is sum is directly the values are coming out when you put it in double quotes. So when you put the directly the variable inside double quotes, the value will be taken from the program and will be displayed. Sum of 29 and 30 is 59. So this solves the problem number 2. Try this problem in the online compiler. The next problem is to basically to understand the various arithmetic expressions. So we have the header files as such, iostream, namespace std, integer main, opening with a curly bracket, correct. Then we have cout, print the result of some specific operation. This will be printed as such. This breaking line will be displayed as such, cout. Okay, let's see this one. Result of first expression is with a colon, directly under the double quotes, so it will print as such. Then directly the values, minus 1 plus 4 into 6. So based on the rule, the 4 into 6 will be executed first. So it will be 24 minus 1, 33. So this won't be read by the computer as it is put in the forward slash. Okay, this is just for the user to understand. Similarly, expression number 2, 35 plus 5 by 7. So modulus 7 means the remainder. So 35 plus 5 will be 40 by 7. When you divide 40 by 7, the remainder will be 5, because 5 into 7 is 35. So a modulus operation will give the remainder. So the value 5 will be printed there. Result of third expression is 14 plus minus 4 into 6. So this will be directly taken. Minus 4 into 6 is 24. Divided by 11. So the calculations for the expression 2 plus 5 by 6 into 1 minus 7 modulus 2. So these are all the basic things of priorities for different arithmetic operators. You can see the current expression here. And when you see this one, directly the first two lines are correct. Then result of expression 1, 2, 3 and 4 is calculated from this programming part, and it will be displayed here. Okay, the next is the same problem like the first and second, is by inputting the values by the user. So you have the IO stream, namespace std, integer main, you are defining number 1, number 2, sum, cout, sum of two numbers. So this will be printed as such. This line is printed as such. This is actually user's version. That means the user want to do like this. This is nothing to do with the output. Then input first number. Okay, then you are putting C in, taking the input number 1. So we can, the screen will be, there will be a cursor like this, you can enter the value. Then input second number, number 2. Sum is the number 1 plus number 2 assigned to sum. Sum of three numbers, sum, C out, end line, return 0. So sum of two numbers, the line, input first number. So he input first 25. Then after number 2, he input 39. When you add the value, you got 64. Next is the problem on swapping of two numbers. So let's see what is swapping also through this problem. Hash include input output stream using namespace std, integer main, the curly bracket, cout, the title of the program, swap two numbers with all the necessary backslash n for taking the new line, the design by the user, integer number 1, number 2, temp. So these are the three variables defined by the user. So input first number, number 1, input second number, number 2. Then number 2 is assigned to temp. So let's see the values also parallelly. So swap two numbers, the line, input first number. So input first value as 25, second number as 39. Then he assigned temp equal to number 2. That means temp will be, in this line, temp will be 39. Then here num 2 is equal to number 1. So here number 2 will be number 2 will be equal to 25. Here number 1 equal to temp. That means temp is a value 39. So 39 will be the new number 1 value. So this is how the swapping takes place in the program. So after swapping, first number is number 1. The latest value, number 1 is 39. And the latest value of number 2 is here, 25. So we given the value number 1, 25, number 2, 39. But we got output as number 1, 39 and number 2, 25. This is called as just a swapping. This will be required for the big programs. But this is actually just a demonstration. Next is on the volume of a sphere. Directly the equation, application, IO stream, std, main, curly bracket. Yeah, after this, you know, this region, you know very well now. Then he defined integer, red one, so radius, float, volume, sphere, because on the calculation, you may get some decimal values. Okay, then calculate the volume of the sphere. Design, input the radius of sphere. So let's see what is the value input. Okay, here the user input value 6. So 6 will come here. 6 will be input here. Volume of sphere is equal to the equation. So we know the value of rad 1, rad 2, rad 3 because 4 by pi into r cube. 4 by 3 pi r cube, yeah. So will be the volume of the sphere. And the calculation will be done and stored in the volume sphere. It is in the float, so even decimals will take. If it was in integer, suppose the value is 4.13, only 4 will come here. Okay, so see out, the volume of sphere is the value. So that's why the value is coming here. Remind that the volume of sphere is defined in float. That's why 904. If it was integer, only 904 will be displayed. Same thing on the cube. I'm not going to the every steps. Side one, float as a volume of cube, calculate the volume of the cube, input the size of cube, and enter the value. Here they inputted the value of 5. A volume of cube is a cube, side cube, a volume of cube, end line, return 0. So directly the values. The values. Even if you define the volume as a integer also, you can get this value. No issues. But it's like a, what I can tell you. The problem can be used for any values. If it was a decimal value for the integer, then you can get a volume of the cube in float also. Suppose you are giving a value 5.5, then you have to define the data type as the float also. So float float will combination will work out. And how to find the area and perimeter, both two things in a same problem. So Airstream namespace integer main, up to here you know very well. Integer width, you need a length, area, perimeter. These are the values to input width and length, area and perimeter to find out. So all the values are put in integer. So that's a important thing, because if you're giving the width and integer in integer, like all number, then area also will be in all number. Find the area of the perimeter, area and perimeter of rectangle, input the length of rectangle. This will be visible, length input. Let's see the values also. They input the length of 10. So 10 will come here. Width is 15. Then here the main equation. Area is equal to length into width. Perimeter is equal to 2 into length into width. So this should be there in the, defined in the variable. It should be taken care. Okay. So define the calculation here. It comes 150 area. Perimeter comes under 50. Then directly taking out the values. Okay, that will do. It will give the output like this. Same thing to find the area and perimeter of circle. I'm not repeating. Only the equation will change to find the values. You need the radius as input, area and circumference or perimeter are the output. Same thing, if you repeat, you will get the values. Here you can use this is a hash define PI is equal to a PI this value. Even you can put directly the values here 3.14, or you can already define as the value of PI is equal to 3.14 well before. It's up to your convenience, the values. We already defined the circumference as well as all the things in float, so there is no issues. Even integer will work in float. Okay, that's the end of the presentation. Thank you.